Okay, I've been wanting to do a test on the adding an exhaust fan on top of the CyberPower i7 11700K with an ASUS RTX 3060 Ti with no overclocking. So I used the FurnMark test. I used the system information viewer that came with the Gigabyte motherboard. I used Task Manager with the performance settings. And I kind of use Core Temp, but you really don't need Core Temp to do this. Basically, what I did is stated on the Excel spreadsheet I show here. I ran the GPU at different states, at idle and stressed, and I changed the fan speeding on top. So basically, on the first line, I have idle, top fan set to low, and the GPU was not stressed. And I got what I show here is 44 degrees at 15% on the GPU fan, and the top fan speed was set at 11% at 677 revolutions per minute. You could see what I have as far as that goes on the right corner. That's how I have my fan profile set. Basically, it doesn't turn the fan on at all during runtime. The noise was quite low indeed because it was idle and the fans weren't really running. And then I ran it with the fan high and I set a different profile for the high one, which I might be able to show here. Let's see. Load profile. Full fan. And that's my full fan profile right there. And you could hear the fans ramp up. So when I was stress testing it, the fans were running at full. When I was idle, it was running at full. And I'm going to bring that down. I don't really want to keep it like that. But what I found out as a verdict that at this performance test is the GPU performance as it relates to the top exhaust fan. Let's see what I have. I kind of messed that up a little bit. Yeah, there it goes. As a top of exhaust fan, really had no effect when the GPU was being stressed. There's a percentage difference, but the temperature stayed at 57 degrees during stressed FurnMark testing on the GPU. And the only time that it affected the GPU was with idle. We had a 4 degree difference. With the top fan set on, the idle was 4 degrees cooler for the GPU. So there is an advantage to that. But the fan noise is noticeable when the top fan is running at high. So I'm going to keep my this in mind when I do the next test. Now the next test was the GPU test, and basically I set it to idle and at stress levels and used the FurnMark to test the CPU while at the time of doing this. And basically, I found out that the top fan has absolutely no effect on the CPU temperatures. It basically made a lot more noise. In fact, it was very noisy. Well, I say very, but noticeably noisier when the CPU was stressed and the top fan was set to high. There was a noticeable increase in sound, which I didn't really want. And it had no effect on the CPU temperatures. So, in the ending, the conclusion is the only reason to run a top fan is if you want the idle GPU temperatures to be lower. And in my case, they were lower by 4 degrees. But in all other cases, it doesn't seem like it's even worth putting a top fan in your CyberPower machine. And personally, I'm going to keep the fan in there, but I'm going to keep it at a low speed. I really don't even want it at a low speed. I wonder what it would run without it being in there. But if I have power issues in the future when I add more hard drives and stuff, that would be the first thing I think about removing is the top fan. Because 4 degrees at idle for the GPU to be 4 degrees cooler, that's just not enough advantage for me to run that fan up there. Imagine putting three fans up there using all that power and making all that noise, and you're really not getting any advantage. Now, I don't have three fans in there. I did have two fans at one time, and I didn't see any difference in CPU temps with those. So at this case, I would think that adding a top fan really doesn't have enough significant difference to keep in the case, if you, unless you want to keep it like I'm going to keep it in there at low speed. That's all I'm going to be running it at.